Go. Good afternoon. How are you doing today?
Hello, how are you?
I'm great, thank you. Thank you for this film. Oh, it was so fascinating. And I wanted to start by asking you, this is a time period that not a lot of people know about. It really is fascinating to me that it's not really talked about, not really reported on. Why was it so important for you to, you've done movies in the past about atrocities in Europe. Why this now?
Well, I think that the surges of the 20th century and this construction of the murderous regime, authoritarian regime, Nazi and Stalinian, are the key to our modernity. It is the period which now many people to compare with our time, with the dangers of the economical crisis and the rise of the populism and ideological and political agendas and authoritarian regimes, etc., etc. So, and I was always like fascinated by this period, which led to the Second World War and to the communist crimes. Nazi and Hitler and Holocaust are entered the global conscience, and the communist crimes, no, and Holodomor, which costed life millions of people in Ukraine and in other parts of Russia, is practically forgotten and forgiven. And I think it's extremely unjust, but also because toward the victims, but also dangerous for the for our understanding of the present and
Yeah,
possible future.
absolutely.
And the point of view of the journalists and the question about the media, the duties and obligations and the corruption of the medias are, I think, like crucial duties for the survival of our democracy. It means with the medias which are not objective, honest, courageous, and investigative and professional, I think that democracy will not survive. So it's why I felt some kind of the urgency when I read the script. That is something which speaks about the past, but it refers to our time without trying to be in fake way actual or relevant or whatever, but because we are living with a similar kind of the challenges and questions.
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah, I was going to ask you about that because, really, in retrospect, has a lot changed? You look at, I fear now for journalists today, for kids that are going to university and colleges who are studying journalism. And now you have the internet where everybody thinks that they're a journalist. And what is real and what is fake and who is controlling it and real journalists who are being put in jail even today because they say something bad about somebody. How do you feel about that?
Well, I feel that unfortunately, we didn't learn enough from the 30s and 40s of 20th century. We did immediately after the Second War. It was a great shock, for example, the political institutions like European Union who have been born from the shock, and the freedom of press and human rights became like important agenda. But paradoxically, after the fall of the Iron Curtain, it started to change and to like this past became the past and not important for us. All the demons are coming back. I'm Polish and I live in France, in US, and in Poland occasionally. And the political situation in Poland is like terrific. I have impression that I see Poland in 37, 38, when the race of the neo-fascist like thinking is close to power. The president. Current president trying to be re-elected is using homophobic and openly fascist language to mobilize, the hate And same they did with the refugees not a long time ago. And, you know, and the underneath they are all the time doing the same with the Jews.
Yeah.
It means those old, you know, old fears and the methods how to feed the fear and how to manipulate the fear and how to lie to the people, how to use the media to spread political ideological propaganda, mm-hmm. and how to use the fake news. It is very similar.
Yeah.
Except that now with the internet, of course, it takes like incredible impact and the speed of light.
Yeah, it's pretty amazing. James Norton, who plays Gareth Jones, the Welsh journalist, mm-hmm. he's wonderful. He's so wonderful in this. He's really, you can see that he just took this role and ran with it. You know, how impressed were you with him and what he did with this role?
Well, you know, I chose him, so I believed in him, and I knew that it is a very difficult role because you don't have like big gestures and you don't have, you know, he's like somehow ordinary, you know, decent man.
Yeah.
We spoke and he told me that he thinks to do it in quite minimalistic way and sometimes use some kind of the awkwardness and humor that he's a little, you know, that he's a little awkward, this young man, but mm-hmm. at the same time, like, you know, ambitious and, you know, so it was like small elements, the puzzles, we built this character and the change which appeared after his travel to Ukraine.
Yeah.
And how good James was in constructing this, I realized only when I cut the film together, you know, because this red line he's like passing is very subtle, you know.
Yeah.
I love him, and he's very, you know, intelligent man and very honest and very generous. So it was real pleasure to work with him.
Yeah, I really, really, really liked his performance. I think this might just catapult him into maybe the next level for sure. He was wonderful. I understand that you shot some of the film in a small village in the Ukraine, where you know it was almost deserted, but you bumped into, mm-hmm. you met some older ladies that lived there that actually mm-hmm. lived through this. And what I find interesting is that, you know, you chatted with them and they said, oh, no, we never talk about it, you know. To me, that's interesting, you know, because my mother came from the Holocaust and escaped Poland with her parents. And we make her talk about things. We make her. I sit there with a recorder mm-hmm. and record the stories just because I want to be able to pass it down, obviously. I find that really mm-hmm. interesting that these women, I guess they just don't want to relive it or, you know.
Well, you know, it was a different situation. The people, the Holocaust survivors, who I had in the family and who I talked a lot when I was doing Europa or other yeah. Holocaust movies, they didn't talk for quite a long time. It means the real, you know, the real memoirs or real talking started only by end of 70s and rather in 80s and 80s. For the long time it was, except of those who lived this experience together with the family. So families like, for example, my film In Darkness, the family of the little girl who survived was talking all the time about this in the family. So it was easier. But those who've been isolated or alone survivors, it was very difficult for them to tell the story. They did it immediately after the war because in several statements. But after it started to come back, it wasn't also, for example, those who emigrated to Israel, they didn't want to be in, the people in Israel didn't want to hear about it, you know?
Yeah.
It was like shameful past. And for Ukrainians, it was different because it was forbidden. You can be sent to you know, to the Gulag, to the concentration camp when you talk about it. So it was the stamp of the silence was put by the regime.
Mm-hmm.
So they didn't talk about it because they've been afraid, but also they didn't talk about it because they've been ashamed. It you know, this experience of famine, if you live through that, is very humiliating.
Yeah.
It's the powerlessness, total powerlessness. And, you know, I'm not talking even about the quite often happening the cases of cannibalism, which in all famines appear.
Yeah, that was a brutal scene. Yeah, that was hard to watch that scene. Yeah. Well, listen, congratulations on this movie. I know you debuted it last year, and it's really, really wonderful. And I hope people get something out of it, you know, really. What would you like them to take out of it at the end of the day?
Well, you know, be careful. Be careful and be courageous, even if it doesn't pay off immediately. It is important for all of us.
Yeah, that is for sure. Well, listen, we can't wait to have you back to come visit us in Toronto in person with another film, and all the best to you. We love having you here, and I love your films. You're just such a wonderful director, and such a pleasure to talk to you today. Thank you for your time.
Thank you. Thank you.